Welcome to a lesson on converting temperature between Celsius and Fahrenheit. We'll derive the formulas used to do the conversions as well as convert between Celsius and Fahrenheit. Since the relationship between Celsius and Fahrenheit is linear, we can determine the conversion equation by determining two key temperatures for both Celsius and Fahrenheit. For example, the freezing temperature for Celsius is 0 degrees, and the freezing temperature for Fahrenheit is 32 degrees. We can represent this information as a point or an ordered pair. This would be the point 0, 32. And the boiling temperature for Celsius is 100 degrees, and the boiling temperature for Fahrenheit is 212 degrees. And we can represent this information as an ordered pair. The second point would be 100, 212. So now that we have two points on a line that relates Celsius to Fahrenheit, we can determine the equation of the line by determining the slope of the line and the y-intercept of the line. So to visualize what we've just done, we're going to use the point 0, 32 and the point 100, 212 to determine the equation of this line, which we can use to convert between Celsius and Fahrenheit. So the first step to determine the equation of our line is going to be to determine the slope given these two points. So we'll go ahead and call this x sub 1, y sub 1, x sub 2, y sub 2. So our slope is going to be equal to 212 minus 32 divided by 100 minus 0. So we'll have 180 all over 100. The greatest common factor of these two would be 20. So the slope of the line would be 9/5. Normally when determining the equation of a line, we also have to determine the y-intercept, which would be b. But in this case, we have the point 0, 32, so 32 would be the y-intercept. So the equation of the line is y equals 9/5 x plus 32. But x actually represents the temperature in Celsius, and y represents the temperature in Fahrenheit. So we'll go ahead and write this in terms of f and c. So we'll have f equals 9/5 times C plus 32. So we'll use this equation to convert Celsius to Fahrenheit. And then to convert Fahrenheit to Celsius, we can just take this equation and solve for C. We could use this equation in its current form, but it will be helpful to solve it for C. So if we have F equals 9/5 times C plus 32, if we want to solve for C, we should subtract 32 on both sides. So we have F minus 32 equals 9/5 times C. And now we can multiply both sides by the reciprocal of 9/5, which would be 5/9. This simplifies to 1C or C. And then we have 5/9 times F minus 32. Let's go ahead and switch this around. Celsius is going to be equal to 5/9 times the quantity F minus 32. And sometimes it may be helpful to write this in the form of 5 times the quantity F minus 32 all divided by 9. So this would be a more convenient formula to convert Fahrenheit to Celsius. Let's take a look at a couple of examples. So to convert 25 degrees Celsius to Fahrenheit, we'll substitute 25 for C to determine F. So I'll write 25 over 1. And notice how we can simplify here. There's 1 factor of 5 here and 5 factors of 5 there. So we'd have 9 times 5, that's 45 plus 32. So we're going to have 77 degrees Fahrenheit. Let's take a look at one more example here. We want to convert 7 degrees Celsius to Fahrenheit. So we'll have 9/5 times 7 over 1 plus 32. And this isn't going to simplify this time, so we'll have 63/5 plus 32. Let's go ahead and convert 63/5 to a decimal. So we'll have 63 divided by 5. So we'll have 12.6 plus 32, which will be 44.6 degrees Fahrenheit. Now let's convert Fahrenheit to Celsius. So again, we have two forms of the equation that we can use. To convert 59 degrees Fahrenheit to Celsius, we'll substitute 59 for F. Minus 32 is 27, so I'll write 27 over 1. And again, this one simplifies nicely. There's one factor of 9 here and three factors of 9 there. So we have 15 degrees Celsius. And for the last example, we'll convert 92 degrees Fahrenheit to Celsius. So 5/9 times 92 minus 32, which is 5/9 times 60, or 60 over 1. Now there's a common factor of 3 here. There are 3 3s in 9, and there are 20 3s in 60. So this would be 100 divided by 3. We'll go ahead and use the calculator. So it's 33.3 repeating. Let's go ahead and round this to the nearest tenth. This should be approximately 33.3 degrees. And that's going to do it for this video. I hope you found this helpful.